this holy mass is offered for the soul of Uncle Henry Meneses. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, we are gathered here to say goodbye to Uncle Henry Meneses. Jesus says, I am the resurrection and the life. Anyone who believes in him will not die, but have eternal life. Yes, Lord, we too believe that though Uncle Henry is not with us, but he is with Jesus and praying for all of us. Uncle Henry come across to me as a simple person. Very generous, always available. And he has really worked hard for this church, went around collecting a lot of fund for the church. Now and then he would call me, Father, I have book for you. I have prepared Sarpadal for you. Main leke aa raha hu. Not because he was generous, but because he loved the fathers and sisters. Uncle Henry, all the fathers and sisters will miss you. Just 1 month back, I went to visit him as a family visit. I spent 1 hour with him, talking to him, listening to him, listening to his problems, worries, tensions, difficulties. I listened to him, I prayed. As I was leaving the place, he had kept 2 envelopes for me. One is the church fund, and the second one, it's for you. Because you came to my house to visit, you came to my house to listen to me, you came to my house to pray for me. My dear friends, as we say goodbye to Uncle Henry, let us ask Jesus to forgive all his sins and give him eternal reward. We also pray for his wife, Molly, and both the children and the family members, that God may be their consolation in these times of loss. For the times we have failed, let us ask God for his mercy and pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, who have strengthened us by the mystery of the cross and promise us a share in the mystery of your Son's resurrection, mercifully grant, we pray, that your departed servant Henry may be gathered into the company of your chosen ones. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. Brethren, do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like this, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him, in order that the body of sin might be brought to nothing, so that we would no longer be enclaved to sin. For one who has died has been set free from sin. Now, if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The word of the Lord.
Please take hymn number 72 on page 23. Hymn number 72. For the gospel acclamation. Please take hymn number 114 on page 32, hymn number 114.
Sing hallelujah. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus came to Bethany, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb 4 days. Bethany was near Jerusalem, about 2 miles away. And many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to console them concerning their brother. So when Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him, but Mary remained seated in the house. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, I know that whatever you ask from God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even though he die, yet shall he live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who is coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to Lord Jesus Christ.
Please take hymn number 123 on page 34. Hymn number 1, 2, 3.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, O Lord, on your servant Henry, for whom we offer you the sacrifice of praise, humbly entreating that reconciled with you through these devoted offices, he may merit to rise again to life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Please take hymn number 465 on page 153. Hymn number 465.
Holy, 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 Lord of our and world. Who comes
are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Lourdes Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Henry Menezes, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles, the martyrs, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespass, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
In case there are any Protestants people over here, I would request not to come forward. All those who are Roman Catholic can come forward to receive the communion.
Please take hymn number 189 on page 58, hymn number 189.
After the final hymn, we'll go to cemetery. I would request only 20 people to be there. Others can go home. Do not come, because only 20 people are allowed in the cemetery. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, says the Lord. and I will not reject anyone who comes to me. Let us pray. Renewed by this life-giving sacrament, we pray, O Lord, that the soul of our brother Henry, to whom you gave a part in your covenant, may be purified by the power of this mystery and rejoice without end in the peace of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended. Go in peace of Christ.
Please take hymn number 393 on page 128. Hymn number 393.
Third day mass tomorrow at 7 in the evening. It's only 50 people, so I would request not many, but very close relatives can come tomorrow evening at 7 p.m. Thank you.
Thank you for that, Father. This is hard. I thank you all for coming today and for being with Daddy for all these years. It means a lot to me, Mom, and Melville. Please do keep Daddy in your prayers. Like Father said, he was a generous fellow, and his life is his generosity, are his actions. It's amazing that all of you all turned up today, and we are grateful for that. So thank you.